So the Bitcoin Cash fork has certainly unnerved the markets. And basically, last year, we had a fork that spawned off Bitcoin Cash from Bitcoin. And basically, there are two warring parties now within Bitcoin Cash, which are splitting into two further currencies. I think the thing to keep in consideration here, Bitcoin Cash is totally separate from Bitcoin. It's its own network. It's got its own drama. I don't think of it as really relevant to the narrative of Bitcoin, even though it does clearly have implications for market sentiment.
All right, let's get back to what Meltem said last night on Fast Money, Chris. And that is, if you're not Bitcoin, you've got probably a liquidity problem. A lot of projects are going to be flushed out. To what degree would you agree?
Meltem's right in that Bitcoin is the bloodline of liquidity to the crypto asset ecosystem. It was the first crypto asset. It's what everything is priced in. And so that is definitely the case. Now, the interesting thing with protocols and their native crypto assets is protocols don't really die the way companies do, right? They from last year, a lot of them have large balance sheets, right? You still have balance sheets in the tens of millions of dollars. And so long as there's one node, one computer online running the software, you've got the protocol live. And if you've got two computers online, the network is live. And so we haven't had this model before. We saw last year many crypto assets come back to life that were presumed dead in bear Sure. markets in past years. And so protocols just don't die the way companies do.
Right. We did see a Bitcoin in the universe basically sort of flatline for some period of time before taking this most recent dip, though, Chris.
The new stable coin.
Excuse me?
Bitcoin is the new stablecoin in that period.
I guess so. I mean, on a relative basis, it sure is. But do you think we've seen the worst of it for 2018? Because there are some people who are so bullish and they're sticking by their 15,000 for Bitcoin by year end, you know, those sorts of prognostications.
So as you know, I'm a venture investor.
Right.
So I've got a 10-year time horizon here. Really, what I'm looking at from a long-term perspective is the 200-week moving average. This goes back actually to my prior work at ARK, where we were the first public fund manager to buy Bitcoin in 2015. And at that period, we based on the 200-week moving average. We were around $200. There was a lot of conversation around the marginal cost of production of a BTC, mm-hmm. and if that was the level that miners needed to continue to sell at in order to cover their operating expenses. There's conversation around the same thing right now. And so if I look, certainly history doesn't always repeat perfectly, but it does rhyme. And it feels like that 200-week moving average, which also represents an 85% drawdown, which is what we had from 2013 to 2015, uh-huh. is, for me, the real capitulation point. That's where you'll see me starting to feel sick.